right? So the university is going to offer a bachelor's degree as well, okay? They typically don't offer...
the master's degree.
Well, no. They offer this. Then they also offer the master's... and they also offer the PhD, yes. And they also offer the PhD, right? Which is also called your doctorate. Doctorate degree as well. Okay? Your doctorate is usually called your PhD. I think it's a doctorate of philosophy, I think is what it is. I think it's in Latin, so it's inverted.
So even though you got a PhD on engineering, you still call you like, you know, PhD, doctor in philosophy?
Well, so there's two types of doctors in English, basically. You have the PhD doctors, and then you have your medical doctors.
Yeah,
medical doctors are also called doctors. The equivalent of a medical degree in the United States is basically a master's. Because you get your bachelor's first, then you go to medical school. Okay? And then the other one, we don't call them doctor in the United States, is your juris doctorate, that's your lawyer. We don't call them doctor. It's technically a juris doctorate, we don't call it that. That's law school, also a master's level program, okay? You can, then after you get your master's, if you keep going, then you get your doctorate, okay? And when you get your doctorate, you have to write, you have to do original research, you have to do the research, you have to get it all approved, and you have to publish a thesis, which is a book. That's what you have to do. You have to write a book and you gotta get it published. And then the school owns the copyright to it. Yes, go ahead.
How long does it take to have a doctorate degree?
God only knows.
God only knows.
Well, because how long does it take you to do your research?
3 days.
Ain't gonna take you 3 days. You gotta write a book about it. It's this big, man. You're writing 200 to 300 pages about your research. Yeah, that's what the PhD is. Everybody that has a PhD has gone through that process. They have to come up with a thesis that they want to defend. It has to be big enough. They have to design the methodology. They got to figure out what they're going to do. They have to conduct the research. Then you have to write it all up. You have to run it through. You have to get it all proofread and checked and everything else. They have to make sure that there are no holes in your thing. And then you have to sit down, take an oral exam. Oh my God, it's a whole thing. Yeah.
Oral exam?
Yeah, an oral exam. Oh, totally. It's called defending your thesis. If you can't talk intelligently about what you did, you're dead. You don't get it.
But we do this in the final project of...
You might. In your country, you do a lot of stuff like that,
yeah,
okay? In the United States, we don't.
I did one big one. Was almost like a book.
Yeah, well, then, did you have your master's degree?
No.
Well, that's for your bachelor's.
Yeah, that's for your bachelor's.
There's another thing before master's that I did.
Okay, that's possible, okay? In the United States, that's what I'm talking about, the U.S. university system, you don't have to do a thesis. You don't have to do any real... I mean, this is not your own original research. You'll do some in classes, but it's not that big. Okay? It's a 4-year degree, 120 credits, that's it, okay? And it's pretty straightforward, okay? Now, let's talk about how we get from here over to here, okay? Hold that thought, let me finish this, otherwise we'll be here all day. Give me a second. So what's important, and I'm gonna tell you a quick little story. So many years ago, I transferred from many schools. I'm gonna tell you my mistakes. You don't wanna do this, this is a bad idea, okay? What happened was, I went to a community college. And at the time, they were offering an associate's degree. I asked my dad, who did not finish university. Nothing wrong with that. I mean, at the time, it wasn't a necessary thing. But he gave me bad advice. He said, son, I said, dad, should I get my associate's degree? He said, well, out in the workforce, we don't really care about it, so don't bother. I said, okay, I'll just transfer. And they said, all your classes transfer when you go somewhere else. Perfect. So I went from one school to another school, transferred, my classes transferred, everything was great. And I took, at the second school, I took ENC 1102, how to write a research paper, okay? Now, because it was an engineering school, they had a special blended class for it, is what happened. So then when I transferred from there to my next school, where I actually got my bachelor's degree from, they transferred all my classes in, and came my final semester, I'm getting ready to graduate, I have a couple more classes I gotta take, and I get an email, or a letter, I don't remember which it was at the time, but they sent me something official, and it said, Mr. Newman, our records show you did not take ENC 1102. I said, what?
What?
I said, I took this ages ago. This was like years ago already. It's long done. What are you talking about? They said, nope, you didn't take it. I said, but I took it over here at Lawrence, at that school. What happened? They said, oh, we checked the course outline with our course outline. They didn't match. We gave you general education credit. You didn't take ENC 1102. I said, but I'm ready to graduate. They said, no, you're not. I said, wait a second. What do you mean, no, I'm not? I took this class. They said, no, you didn't. I said, I don't want to take that class. They said, nice. They asked me, do you want to graduate? I said, yes. They said, you're taking ENC 1102.
Oh, no.
I said, you're kidding. They said, no. And they made me take ENC 1102, my final semester of college, absolutely, of university. That's exactly what happened. Now, of course, at that point, all the good teachers were gone. So I had the worst teacher ever for my ENC 1102 class. We all hated him. Every kid in the class hated this professor. But anyway, that's a different story. So, but you don't want that to happen to you, right? That's a lot of shocking news for your last semester. Why did that happen? Give me one second. Just hold your thoughts. I'll come back to you. What happened was, if I had gotten my associate's degree, it's a stamp that says those first 2 years, ENC 1101, ENC 1102, Speech 101, all my philosophy, all my humanities requirements, my physical science requirements, my history requirements, all of those are done. We don't check anymore. We verify that you got your associate's degree, you're good to go, you're all set. Thank you so much, have a nice day. And they don't bother checking. Your classes will transfer, but what they'll do is they will check every individual class that you have taken. That's how they do it, okay? So what does that mean? That means if you're planning on transferring to another school, you either go pretty quick after the English program, or I would recommend you get your associate's degree, so when you get over here, you don't have the same problem I did. Does that make a little sense?
Yeah.
All right, Eugene, your question.
When you have two doctor degrees? Yes, doctor's degrees.
How do you
okay,
do
you? Go ahead.
In French, you said you have a postdoctor.
There is postdoctorate work available, yes. To my knowledge, I don't know that we call it postdoctorate. I don't know. I know there's postdoctoral work which exists, right? It's called a postdoc. Postdoctorate work. But to my knowledge, it's not a degree. If you want another degree, you get another PhD, is my understanding. Yeah. And if you have two PhDs,
double doctor.
Yeah, well, we don't call you doctor. We don't do that. It's just one doctor still. So that's all it is. I'm not sure. Say again? Yeah, I mean, if you have two, then great. You're super smart. I mean, if you want to show off, you tell people, I have two doctorates. Okay. Super smart. Did a lot of work. Sorry? Yeah, exactly. Good for him. I don't know that you make any more money. Whatever. All right, over here, Kyle.
Yeah, it makes a lot of difference when we put on the resume.
Your resume?
Yeah. What universe you went to?
Let's talk about that for a second. Here's how it works, basically. The way it works is the bachelor's degree depends on the reputation of the school. Most employers don't look too close about, you know, did you get something related to what we want? That's great. But the primary thing that you're looking for here is the reputation of the school. Over here, it's the reputation of the program within the school for your master's. Okay? When you get to your doctorate, what you want to check is who your mentor is going to be. Because your mentor has all the connections that will connect you with who you need to do to continue your work in the field you want to study. That's how you check. So I will tell you, if you're going to transfer to a university, get your associate. And by the way, the associate's degree that you want is the Associate of Arts, not the AS. The Associate's of Science doesn't transfer. The Associate's of Arts does. The AA, yes. The Associate of Arts degree transfers. The other ones do not.
Why?
That's how it works. Why? Because they don't.
No, I don't get it.
Right. Oh, okay. But, yes. So that's what we have. Does that make a little more sense now?
Yeah.
There you go. All right.